In this video, we discuss 9 pre-patterns for handheld augmented reality game design. Applying embodied metaphors to handheld devices suggests both their function and possible actions a user can take. The game Bug Juice uses a magnifying glass metaphor, implying that bugs can be burned if the player maintains the proper distance. Joe Warpin uses a 2D overlay of a sniper reticle, while continuous rumble and screen jitter suggest that the player is in a helicopter. The game Space Runner also uses a 2D overlay. In this case, the wireframes suggest the cockpit of a spaceship maneuvering through a tunnel. The way physical actions are mapped to actions in the digital game world can have a profound effect on the game experience. In the AR marble game, controlling the virtual world through the use of physical objects, including the game board, makes interaction natural and intuitive. Inch-high Stunt Guy uses ray casting from points on the display to points in the hybrid space, allowing fine control over objects that have no physical counterparts. Nerd Herder uses the position and orientation of the device itself, letting players leverage their bodily awareness in the physical space for control over virtual game elements. Handheld augmented reality has technical limits that must be accounted for in game designs. Loss of tracking and registration can be handled in a number of ways. Players in Joe Warpin begin to take damage when approaching the distance boundaries of the tracking technology. The ominous noise and flashing red screen cause players to instinctively move to a new position and restore tracking incidentally. In Paparazzi, marker tracking and accelerometer-based position tracking correlate to different game mechanics. Transitions between these two technologies preserve a continuous play experience. The Nintendo 3DS provides explicit text-based instructions for interacting with the technology and written feedback during the registration process. A consistent or inconsistent relationship between properties of the physical and virtual worlds set expectations of what is possible in the hybrid game world. Candy Wars maintains gravity and exaggerates the characteristic physical properties and behaviors of objects to match with user expectations of gameplay. Levelhead maps multiple spaces into the volume of a single cube, creating a hyperspace that is impossible in physical reality. Yet the multiple faces of the cube make this impossible space seem entirely plausible and even intuitive. Identical landmarks in the physical and virtual worlds leverage players' environmental skills to help generate a unified and functional frame of reference for the hybrid space. The fountain in the center of the marker board in R is distinct from the other models and plays an integral role in the gameplay, assuring its significance for players. The puzzle game Levelhead uses 2 strategies to help users build mental maps of complex spaces. Rooms are clearly marked with names, and colored lights help players note entrances and exits, as well as provide visual reminders for transitions between spaces. Characters that seem alive feel like they inhabit the physical world, and invite players to interact with them using natural social skills. The iPet is situated in the physical environment and reacts to real-world events. Shopping for your character increases the personal connection and reinforces their personality. The personal dramas of Swapu characters make them seem like social creatures with rich inner lives. Their physical construction is both cute and functional. Trackable features capture their individuality and help the user make a personal connection. Handheld augmented reality adds enhanced feelings of personal presence to common video game conventions for representing the player in the digital space. Characters in the game R attack players when they miss a shot, making them feel like they are a part of the action. The math game Puppy Plus does not represent the player in the hybrid space at all, creating a more detached and reflective game experience that is ideal for learning. Rock'em Sock'em Robots gives the player an avatar to control at the same scale as the other game objects, creating a level playing field that makes for balanced play. Constraints of the player's bodies in the physical space create opportunities for designers to leverage unconscious bodily awareness and create social situations that enhance gameplay. In Bragfish, players use their bodies strategically to block other players' actions and achieve favorable positions for their own. Domino Knockdown attempts to avoid physical contact and contention for ideal positions by employing algorithms that dynamically adjust each player's view of the game space based on their physical position. Maintaining private information, creating a shared hybrid space, or combining both offers opportunities to enhance social aspects of handheld augmented reality game designs. In the fishing game Bragfish, the opponent's actions are hidden from view, forcing the player to infer that information from bodily behavior. Eye of Judgment combines a game mechanic typically found in competitive card games with AR technology to lend social significance to the act of revealing hidden information.